Happy Pride Month. I do listen to Girl in Red. I love women. And I would share my coming out story with you, but I don't have one. I wasn't outed or anything. I just never formally came out to people because I didn't want to. Instead, I'm gonna say this. It really freaking sucks that we don't get to celebrate Pride as normal this year due to COVID-19. However, because it's not safe for us to go out and parade and party, we have a little bit of extra time on our hands. And what better way for us to spend that time than educating ourselves on queer history? I'm not gonna take up a whole lot of time here to talk about it. I'm gonna leave resources in the description, but the baseline is this. The original Pride wasn't a parade. It was a riot led by queer women of color. Today's queer community would not be able to party it up like we do every June if it wasn't for people like Marsha P. Johnson, like Sylvia Rivera, like Stormy DeLarvery, and so many more queer women of color who were protesting police brutality against queer people back in 1969 at the Stonewall riots. Most important thing you gotta know is this. If you're condemning the protesting and rioting going on against police brutality today, if you're condemning the Black Lives Matter movement, then it's not fair for you to celebrate Pride. Because this happening right now, this is largely the root of queer liberation. That's all I really have to say. As a cis white queer person, my voice is not the one that should be primarily heard right now. However, being aware of my privilege gives me more of a reason to speak out. If you have a voice, if you have a platform, use it. Silence is compliance. Yeah, that's it. Like I said, I'm gonna leave resources below. Happy Pride Month!